Hello, in this video I will be formatting dates, and specifically I will be getting the current day of the week. Now there are a lot of resources for this on the web, but I find it a little time consuming to get all the available options and see what types of format you can use. So in this video I will review some of these options. I will be using the routing of Laravel, just so I can easily display the formats inside the browser. And for the purpose of this demo, I will be working with Carbon, but this can be done with a simple PHP DateTime object. And now let's just display a simple format in the browser. When I refresh, we get the current year. Now for the current day of the week, one of the most popular formats is capital D. This will give us a short version of the day. If we want the full name of the day, we can use lowercase l. And these two options might cover a lot of use cases and might be sufficient. But another option that we have are the ISO formats, and to get the same thing I need to tap for these here. When I refresh, it's again the full name of the day. If I remove a letter, we get a short version of the day, and if we have just double this, it's a two-letter version of the day. We can also get a numeric value of the day. I can use the day of week property, and when I refresh, this will give us 4 for Thursday. One thing to note is that these days are 0 based, and 0 starts with Sunday, 1 is Monday, 2 is Tuesday, and so on. With the number of the current day, you can do your own implementation and have a custom map for each day. So I want to create a map which is basically an array, and the keys are going to be my custom names for each day. So 0 is for Sunday, let's have one for Monday, and I'll jump straight to 4 for Thursday. And to use this map, we just have to get the index of the current day from the array. When I refresh in the browser, we get our custom implementation of the day. And if this is useful for your case and you want to use this on multiple places in your application, you can create a Carbon macro. So I will copy all of this, and right here I will create a Carbon macro. I'm going to call it my day. And here in the callback, I'll just paste everything that we had before. Now inside the page, I want to return a carbon, and we call this macro my day. We need to call this as a function. I need to use capital D here, of course. And when I refresh the browser, we get the same result. But now I can repeat this portion everywhere inside my application. This was all for this video. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them below in the comments. And thank you for watching.